Cisco Firepower SSL decryption policy gives the capability to inspect SSL encrypted contents over the network. Otherwise, encrypted traffic such as HTTPS connections, which make up most of the internet content, cannot be inspected. In the last section, we implemented decrypt resign method where users inside the network browse all HTTPS SSL applications outside the network with Firepower certificate. In this section, we implement decrypt noun key method in which users from outside the network access our HTTPS SSL applications inside the network with server's real certificate. But traffic will be first decrypted and inspected in Firepower before they are forwarded to the server. In the last section, we talk about Cisco Firepower decryption policy and its applications. But just to implement the second application, it is not bad to review the concept. There are two main applications of SSL decryption policy. In the first application, when a user inside the network browses an HTTPS application outside the network, the content of the website is decrypted by Cisco Firepower so it can be inspected. After inspection, the content is re-encrypted and resigned before being forwarded to the user. This method is also called decrypt resign method. With this method, Cisco Firepower gives its own certificate to internal users instead of real server certificate. From the user's perspective, all websites are trusted by Cisco Firepower certificate. This method requires that users inside the network trust Cisco Firepower certificate. In the second application, we are the owner of SSL applications inside the network. Users from outside the network get the services from our applications. In this method, we decrypt and inspect the content in Cisco Firepower to prevent any outside malicious content from reaching the servers. In this method, Cisco Firepower must have server certificate and also its private key so that it can decrypt and inspect all content from users outside the network to the server's destination. This method is called decrypt noun key since Firepower has the private key of the server. There are four steps to implement the second type of Cisco Firepower decryption policy or decrypt noun key. First, copy server certificate and its private key to the Firepower. The first step is to copy the server certificate and its private key into Firepower. Firepower can decrypt and inspect encrypted traffic, this time for the server, using server's private key. Second, configure SSL policy to decrypt and inspect. In the second step, we configure an SSL policy to decrypt and inspect our interesting encrypted traffic. And then enable SSL policy in access control policy. The SSL decryption policy will not decrypt or inspect any SSL traffic until it is activated in access control policy. And the last step, test, monitor, and troubleshoot the decrypt noun key SSL decryption policy. Then we will access HTTPS servers from outside to decrypt and inspect the traffic in Firepower and also monitor the connection events generated by Cisco Firepower. In the first step, I have to copy server certificate and private key to the Firepower. But before that, I want to show you how I prepared the server certificate and its private key using OpenSSL software. I'm using this certificate and private key to configure an HTTPS server. They are also transferred to the Firepower to decrypt and inspect encrypted traffic, this time to the server. Just to know, I've downloaded Windows version of OpenSSL software from this site. Version 11M is the version that I've installed in my computer. After installation, a folder is created in program files, OpenSSL win64. Then inside the bin folder, I'm there. At the first step, I create a 2048 bit RSA public private key pair with the following command: copy and then paste. RSA key pair is created. I use the name raiko-code.local.key for my RSA key pair. In the second step, we generate a certificate signing request with the help of RSA key pair with the following command: copy and then paste. A CSR is generated with the name of raiko-code.local.csr, the country name IR, state Tehran, city Tehran, organization Raika, organization you need security, for example, common name www.raika-code.local, email address info@raika-code.local, and finish. A CSR is generated. This is our RSA key pair and this is our CSR file. Edit with Notepad. Copy. Then we give the CSR to certificate authority to receive a certificate. Advance, and we paste CSR here, and we use web server as a template since this certificate will be used for web server. If you don't know how to install and configure Microsoft CA, I've already explained it in a lesson named SD-WAN Certificate Authority Configuration in SD-WAN course. And then submit and then download. Raiko-code.local certificate. Then we have to copy certificate and also private key both in server and firepower. I don't want to show you how I have used certificate and private key to bring up a sample HTTPS website with the address www.raiko-code.local. This is sample website with HTTPS connection. I don't want to show you how I have already configured web server since there are many methods and software that you can use, like IIS, Apache, and Nginx. But I show you how I have copied the certificate and private key in Cisco Firepower. In Cisco Firepower, objects, object management, PKI, internal certs, and then add internal certs. For example, raiko-code.local, we have to copy the certificate, raiko-code.local.cer, and the private key, raiko-code.local.key. I've already created, so I don't want to save it. Notice that Enterprise Certificate CA must be trusted by Cisco Firepower since it has signed already server certificate at trusted CA. First, we have to download the certificate from Certificate Authority. Download a CA certificate. Download CA certificate. Change the name to CA, for example, and then rows and choose CA certificate. I've already trusted Raika Enterprise CA certificate. You can search it here with Raika keyword. I've already copied, so I don't save it. It is also worth mentioning that CA and server certificate must be trusted by all users outside the network. Otherwise, they will get a certificate error message when browsing our web server. In the next step, we have to add a SSL policy in Cisco Firepower policy and then SSL policy 1. We have already created in the previous video. Here I've added a new rule. Let's open it with the name raika-code.local with the action decrypt noun key and with the certificate raika-code.local that we have already copied into Cisco Firepower. It belongs to the server and we have already copied to the Cisco Firepower with its private key, so we can decrypt and inspect the traffic designed to the server for traffic from outside zone to the inside zone, for the network to the destination 192.168.10 from internet, and for the application for the ports, HTTPS ports, and logging is also enabled. Don't forget in SSL policy to trust also CA certificate. Here we have already in the previous video, in the previous scenario, we have trusted Raika Enterprise Certificate Authority in our SSL policy, but make sure that you don't forget. And SSL policy rule is ready. The rule is actually to decrypt all SSL traffic using decrypt noun key action. We have choose the server certificate and private key as the key to be used to decrypt the traffic this time to our web servers. It is already ready. And SSL policy will not work until it is activated in access control policy. In the previous video and previous scenario, we have already enabled our SSL policy in access control policy. Here, SSL policy is SSL policy 1, which is here. SSL policy 1. Now we can check our HTTPS website from outside the network to evaluate our SSL policy. We check it again. This is our outside computer and web server is located here in inside computer. We expect the traffic will be decrypted and inspected by Cisco Firepower. But how can I check it? I can check it with connection wizard analysis, connection events, edit search, and for URL, https www.raika-code.local, and then search. This is https://raika-code.local. We check the table view of the connection. And we add three new fields, like what we have done in the previous scenario, SSL. To show SSL rule, SSL policy, and also SSL actual action. As you can see, the traffic from 192.168.188 to 192.168.10.10 from outside to the inside, HTTPS, SSL status, decrypt noun key, SSL actual action, also SSL policy 1, the name of the rule is royco-co.local, as we have already created, HTTPS, and for URL, www.royco.co.local. So we have decrypted the traffic for the destination of our internal servers.